Today we're going to make a fantastic flexi design using bundle groups and the sketch tool, so let's get cracking. Today, friends, we're going to start with a bit.ly to get to a template. If you type bit.ly/flexsnake, that will take you to the template. It has the sketch tool aimed a special way for the project. Of course, it's set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy and tinker. All right, so friends, of course, this is Tinkercad. When you do copy and tinker, you get my exact design I was working on. Right now, it's just got the welcome tutorial. Of course, there may be more notes later as we build. Now, this is called the sketch tool. When it normally comes out, we drop it like this, and we're working top down. I'm going to hit finish sketch because you can see this one is standing up, and that is because for this flexi snake, we want to work from this angle. Now, we do not need this cube anymore. That was just how I lined it up. I'll show you real quickly, just like I entered here and exited. Same thing there. L for align, click on that, and of course, I wanted it to go center and to the bottom. That's all I did to make that for you. Now, real quickly, let me show you what we're going to build. This is just a cool little connector. You can see these click through. There's a gap on each side. And then we added the little pieces for our snake or worm or whatever you want to call it. Now, of course, this uses two of my favorite tools. It uses Sketch and it uses the new bundle feature. Friends, let me show you how it works. Let's zoom in a little bit, double click on our sketch. So we're going to draw this part 6 millimeters over. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This would be 6. We're going up 2 millimeters. We're going diagonal 1 millimeter. We're going to go back the 4 millimeters. We're going to go diagonal. And then we're going to go diagonal. We'll go back 2 millimeters and we'll go down 2 millimeters and then we'll connect it. So we've just made this with sharp lines. It's just a tiny little part. This is going to be our connector. Double click it so you can edit it. We're going to keep these sharp, but let's go to this one right here. And let's hit number 2 to make it rounded. I'm also going to hit this one right here and press number 2 to make it rounded as well. This is connector number 1 for our part. Simply hit finish sketch, D to drop so it's at 0 level. And then we can zoom in and check it out. I don't like this dip. So I'm going to double click and we're going to edit it. And we just want to double click to get in here and make sure that this little piece is up so that it does not go down and up. Set my nudge to 0.1. Grab that point and just make it so that it stays on an upward slope the whole time. And hit finish sketch. You can tweak and adjust that as much as you need. Now we're going to do Control D, shift nudge to move it to the other side, double click to get in it, and we want it to flip the other way. We can flip by just changing the number to its exact opposite. Positive 6 becomes negative 6, bang. That is now aimed the way we want. Now we do want these to cross into each other. I'm going to just make sure that I leave a little bit of gap that way. Switch my nudge to 0.1 so I can adjust a little bit more precise. And then I'm going to just take this, double click and edit. And I want this line to come up. We can do this with the arrow keys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we've got a 0.5 millimeter above. I'm going to click on this line right here and go down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to bring this hole back over. So I'm just going to click on this and I'm going to go shift nudge. Check it out. It does a whole millimeter. Then I can grab this point. And I'm just going to aim it so that it has that slope that I want to go all the way through. I'm even going to bring this point all the way down here and then check this out. If we hit number 1, it makes a straight line. It switches to that easy. I think I want that to be a straight line as well. And you can see now that these two run into each other. That is the exact part we want. We can now hit finish sketch. Now for these to collide, we're going to set this one to 6. We're going to set this one to 3.5. And we're going to press enter. Select the two, choose L for align, and let's make this one the boss and get it just like that. Now we need one more of these. We're going to use it in a minute, so let's do Control D and just nudge that back there for later. and now we need to cut out our connection areas. Bring out a hole cube. We're going to take this hole and we're going to make it 4.4. Notice that'll leave us a gap on both sides. And then we're going to change this measurement to 3 and press enter. And let's change this measurement to 4 and press enter. That leaves it sticking out a little bit. We're going to line this up by hiding this one, selecting it all, L for align. Of course, the blue one needs to be the boss, and we want it to be centered. And for a moment, we're going to move it all the way to the front. Once again, make sure your nudge is set to 0.1, and we're just going to move it back one click. This gives us a nice solid part in front and the hole inside. If we do Control G to group, bang, there is your first connector. Do show all to bring back the other connector. And as you can see, we just need to cut a hole out of this. We could, of course, do it with a cylinder, but instead I'm going to do it with the same sketch tool. We're going to do Control D. We're going to make it a hole, and we're going to edit that hole. Of course, the part that's there, we don't want, but this allows us to be in the exact spot so we can see where we want this cutout area to be. We're going to simply make sure our nudge is set to 0.1, and I want to go a little bit above, a little bit past, and I'm making a diamond, so I'm trying to line these up straight above and over and finish. It's not perfect. I can try and make it perfect by just using the arrow keys. It really doesn't matter, though, because all I'm going to do is double click, and we have got the shape we want. I'm going to turn this a little bit so there's a little more material on this side, right in here. If these numbers are ever in your way, notice you can always just click and get rid of them. Right now we've got the handles set to smooth. I can also press number 3 and break those so they adjust independently so I can get the exact slope I want for that pin area. Same thing here, 3, and I can just get that adjusted the way I want. I'm happy with that, so I'm going to hit finish sketch. And now we can connect those. I'm going to hide this for a moment so it's easy to see and do Control G to group. Show all to bring them back. Bang, we have got a connector that will print in place and spin. Now notice how this is only half. Let's add a little bit of strength to this pin. Pull out a cylinder. I'm going to shift squeeze and make it 1.8 because I'm thinking that's about the right size. I'm going to make it much longer, and let's rotate it so it's the right way. Remember, when you rotate, this is 22.5 degrees per turn. Now we can simply drag this close to in place. Once you get it where you think it's pretty good, make sure your nudge is low. I'm going to do control down to drop it in place, and then double check our measurements and group. Remember, we needed 6, so I'm going to set this to 6. Select those two, choose L for align, and of course I want it to be in the center this way. When you're happy, we can select those two and do Control G to group. Bang, we have just created the part that's going to make our snake wiggly. All right, so if we look at the hole from this spot to this spot, that has to be able to move. We're going to use a very cool bundle group to make this happen. This is the magical part of today's project. Real quickly, 5 millimeters is the gap in there. So we're going to go back to this shape. We're going to double click it so that we're editing it. Make sure you've got your dimensions back on. Notice this is 5 millimeters, which is the number we want, but we're going to hit delete and start again. So I'm stretching it across 5 millimeters. Got my nudge set to 0.5. I'm going to go up 3 millimeters, and I'm going to go over and up to the half millimeter. That's why we did the 0.5, and we're going to click, and we're going to finish. All straight lines, but if we double click, we can click on this one, press number 2, and it rounds it instantly. Now, I want it a little more sloped, so I'm just going to pull these straight out. Notice if you twist, it gets wonky. If you stay straight, you can make the perfect design in an instant. I'm also going to grab these, and I'm going to go down one click. So we ended up having this measurement right here be 2.5. If you want to click on this line, it'll show you 3.54 on each side because we had those handles straight. If we hit finish sketch and turn that into a hole, it is now going to be the tool that cuts everything we do over here. Now, to line this up correctly, we're going to grab these for a moment and do Control B to bundle. That way they are one part. Notice bundling was instant and has the green line. Select the two, L for align, and we're going to just choose center, and I'll also choose center. So I'm going to explain the bundle group in a moment, but I do want to make this one a little bit lower. Double click on it, and from that front, we're going to double click again, and let's just grab all the top ones. Once again, with our nudge at 0.5, we're going to just move that down until it's right there. We want to make sure it goes above this hole, but we don't need a ton of material above. If you wanted to click on this one and just bring it down another half millimeter, you can as well. You'll find out in a minute how that works. So now let's click on our bundle and unbundle it. So we simply grab it all and do Control B to bundle. Notice it's instant, and even though this was a hole, it does not cut out. Friends, let me show you how cool this is. If I zoom all the way out, we can find our cool cube. I'm going to show you real quickly that if you type numbers, these can have an awesome radius. I'm going to put the number 6 here, and we're going to do a length. We're going to make our snake 8x8. Notice how these snap and it becomes kind of round. And then I'm going to choose a length of 15. These are going to be the snake pieces. This will just pop on either side of this, and eventually it'll wiggle. To make it easier to print, though, we're going to trim the bottom. We're going to do that simply by bringing out a cube, and let's set this to 1 and press enter. And then we'll line those up. L for align, center, center. And of course, it has to be at the bottom. Take those two and do Control G to group, D to drop so it's flat. And then this just drops right in this spot. I'm going to do Control D to make another one and put it on the other side, making sure that they do poke through both sides. So I'm giving a little bit of gap. And then here's where it gets magical. This hole cannot cut the parts inside because they're bundled. The hole can cut this piece right here. So even if I move this closer, I'm going to make sure that it bumps into this blue part. And of course, that one's bumping into the blue part. I'm going to grab them both and do L for align and make sure that they're centered, which they were. If we grab these two parts and the bundle, and we do Control G to union group, check it out. This part trimmed away so that those are still separate. That, my friends, is how we make our snake. I'm going to ungroup this now so I can make the other pieces. Once again, Control D and shift nudge to move that out front. Get the gap however I want. I'm going to click on this one and do Control D and move it back. Of course, we want to finish with a head and a tail. You can see here the head. If we double click to look inside it, all I did was take that part and shrink the distance this way so that it was smaller. And these are places where I'll insert filament once it's done printing. This technique is simply to bring this little guy out. And then I like to use the number 1.85. You can test your printer to see what it works with. I stood these up. I rotated it a few degrees this way. And I also like it to be a few degrees this way. And then I did Control D and flipped it the other way so that the eyes were looking out. Now I do want to note, I did Control B to bundle. Once again, that is because it is super instant. And then I took those and I lined them up by grabbing the two, choosing L for align, making that the boss, and choosing center. Now I do want those eyes to cut in, and of course I've got to connect it, so I'm going to line it up with where it would connect. Of course I've ungrouped these so I can add the other pieces, because the less you group things together, the better. Looks like I can move that forward a click. And then for the tail, all I did was bring out the paraboloid. If I double click on it, you can see I trimmed the bottom, and I trimmed this with a sketch shape. Once again, just brought this out. I made an angle so it looked the way I want, and then I cut off 1 millimeter down below. When you click, that cuts off, and as you can see, it turned out pretty darn slick. Once again, nudge it into place. I'm going to delete these eyes. Let's make sure it's all lined up. L for align, make this the boss, and choose center. Friends, right there, we have just created a sweet snake. One final control G to group. Notice the union group does take a little longer. Of course, you can make these any length you want. I'm gonna take this one right now though, and I'm gonna quickly send it for 3D printing. We simply hit export. I'm gonna choose STL. I'm gonna put it in my 3D modeling folder, and I'm gonna call it Flexi Snake, and hit save. Then we can bounce to Bamboo Lab Studio. I'm gonna hit add. There is my Flexi Snake. We can bring it in. I am gonna change the color. I wanna use the awesome bubble gum from Polar Filament. And we can hit slice. And check this out, friends. We're gonna have a fun little Flexi Snake in about 13 minutes. Simply hit print, double check that color, and send it to the 3D printer. And about 13 minutes later, check it out. We have got an awesome little Flexi Snake. Here you can see the one I printed yesterday with green eyes. And this is the awesome Polar Filament bubble gum. I simply snip off the end and twist a little bit to insert it, clip it off, and of course, repeat for the other side. How cool is that? All right, so friends, I do want to stress, angles can be adjusted. There's lots of room for you to make this cooler. I just wanted you to see the technique and how that bundle group allowed you to cut away the outside. And because it was in a bundle, it did not cut the parts that were inside the bundle. Friends, I think this trick is the coolest thing ever. Of course, make sure you stay tuned because I'll have more to come. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that support me via YouTube memberships. Friends, there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. Don't forget, with any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, a huge shout out to my Patreon group. Love how the group is growing. We have surpassed 200 members. It has a fantastic messaging area, all kinds of great information there. Of course, you can ask questions as well for free. Don't forget, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.